Well, it's day 6 and I'm gonna do something which is quite fun, as my kid used to enjoy this joyride. We're gonna do this one. I was just walking around a shopping mall and I saw this cute Tom Jerry ride. We're gonna sketch this in a postcard as my number 6. Well, we start with the outline. Very simple outline, the whole thing, macro view first, right? Without the detail. Basically, to get the proportion right. At least you know you got a proportion right. Anyway, even though it's a skewed a little, but it's a sketch, so that's fine. Now we go in with the details. As you can see, the drawing, if you get the macro right, the micro can sort itself out. Everything is about proportion. It's about getting, markers down one at a time, coming from the outside in, not from the inside out. Macro to micro, not micro to macro. And every line is hang off the outline. In a ratio, in a sense of ratio, in a sense of proportion. Even though I make so many mistakes with the drawing, but because of the outline, it will look okay. And I think even though the sketch is skewed and squashed somewhat, but overall it will still look proportionally correct, because I did the outline first, right? I mean, that's why you don't go wrong. And I'm gonna use my favorite trick as well, starting with a shadow first. To train my eye to see where the shadows are, and once I see that, I can sort of have a bit more confidence in getting the three-dimensional form of the sketch in. Softening the edges of the shadow is very important, because shadow will always have softer edges compared to the object itself. You can't have a sharper shadow, right? That's just not reality. That's not how our eyes would see it. Definitely not how our mind would interpret it. So always soften your shadow. If I go in, I'm just going in with a small brush to do more of the shadow shapes, basically. Then I'm going to look in to the various colors. One of the things you need to keep in mind is that because they are almost metallic in its look, there will be blown out, basically highlights in the colors. That has to be left completely white, paper white if you like. So I'm just going in with reds, leaving highlights, going in with green, leaving in some highlights as well, where it's appropriate, and looking at the various colors, again, I'm just going in with as pure color as I can. One more thought I'll leave with you is that when I put in pure color, I try not to use a single hue or a single color. I will drop in a combination of different colors. So for example, for yellow, it'll be lemon yellow with a bit of cadmium red, which is a bit more warmer. And then if I drop in the green, which is green gold, I drop in a bit of the phthalo green, and so on and so forth. So, multiple color in one shape. Even though the shape can be small, but your eyes can certainly see the difference, the different colors that you drop in. Tom, the cat, is gray, so I mixed a gray out of green and red, basically phthalo green with permanent alizarin crimson, and water it down to make sure that it's not too dark. And that becomes my mid-tone gray, and I'm just laying it down where I see fit. Leaving lots and lots of white. I'm conscious that there's a lot of blown out highlights in the photograph, and you should be able to kind of see it yourself, and then you can just have your brush dance around to mimic the highlight as well. I'm almost at this point drawing with my small brush, which is something that I don't recommend that you do, but because it's a postcard sketch and it's a lot of fun, you can draw in quote with your brush. You should be laying down color with your brush, not draw. You should be drawing with your pencil and pen, not draw with your brush. But in this case, as you can see, I'm drawing with my brush. There's nothing wrong with it per se, but usually it becomes sketchy. It's something that will, the results that you create out of this sketchiness may not be a nice sketch, if you like, but it's certainly not a wrong thing per se. You know, as I progress, the drawing part of with the brush becomes more and more of a painting, because, you know, I'm doing bigger and bigger sort of shapes, if you like. When you're doing very, very small shape and you're just drawing lines with your brush, you know, that's kind of basically it's drawing with your brush, and that's not really a good thing, generally speaking. So sometimes as I am progressing, I do need to let the sketch dry before I progress. One of the biggest culprit of bad watercolor is impatient. So you really need to, you know, build up your stamina or patience, if you like, and learn to see your sketch, or at least your first or second layer, dry before you go to the next layer, right? So that's what I'm doing. Sometimes I, you know, put my name, I'm just waiting for time and waiting for the sketch to dry or become drier by just, you know, observing, evaluating, putting down name, date, and so on and so forth. Not necessarily a bad thing, it's just a habit that I have, even though it's just a 15-minute sketch, you're seeing in a speed up manner, but you know, it's something good that you should learn, which is to practice patience in all your watercolor sketch. So now at this point, more details, probably putting in a bit more shade, making more three-dimensional form for the objects that I'm seeing in front of me. It's a little bit too flat for my liking, so you know that in order to create form, it is, or three dimension, it is important to use gradient. It's important to look at shadows, and you know, just to evaluate more and more based on the photograph I'm seeing, and just, you know, copying what I see, and sometimes try to switch off my active mind that is getting in the way of you know, getting a good sketch. Basically, I missed out the handle, so I'm putting that back in, and strengthening some of the darks, strengthening some of the shadows, and that should be it. So I hope you enjoyed this sketch and this series. I'm in number 6 at this point. Not sure I have the energy to do all 28 videos. I probably will do a sketch. I'm not sure whether I'll be able to do all the videos though. So stay safe wherever you are. I hope you will stay well. And this is WeTake out.